Welcome back to our channel Dentistry to the Point. So today in this video we're going to start with a new fresh topic, that is exfoliative cytology. Now this is actually a small topic, a short note topic, usually asked in your oral path exams or even sometimes in your oral medicine exam, and actually a general topic which I think every one of you should know, because this is a very common term which is used in the diagnosis of many diseases like biopsy and exfoliative cytology. So I think this video is going to be helpful, and listening to this video will make all your concepts clear. So starting with exfoliative cytology. Now as the name itself suggests, exfoliative or exfoliate means to shed off something, to throw off something, and cytology is nothing but the study of cells. So the definition goes as, it is the study or a microscopic study of cells which exfoliate or abrade from the body surface. Simple. The rationale of exfoliative cytology is, now rationale meaning what? That is any reasons. When you give, rationale is nothing but set of reasons or logical basics you give for anything. So the rationale or reason is, because it lies, the rationale of this exfoliative cytology lies in the epithelial physiology. So what happens is, normal epithelium undergoes exfoliation of its superficial cells due to physiologic turnover. Okay, now what is that turnover? Turnover is nothing but a continuous process. Okay, like the cells, they have their physiologic time limits, ki they pay off with their function, then they shed off and new cells takes place. So that is a physiologic turnover. So normal epithelium undergoes exfoliation of its superficial cells due to physiologic turnover, but the cells of the deeper layers are adherent to each other normally. But when the epithelium becomes a seat of any pathological condition, the cells may lose their cohesiveness, the deeper cells, okay? And the cells in the deeper layer may shed off along with the superficial cells. So these exfoliated cells, as well as the cells which are scraped off by means of specific instruments, can be studied, okay? So this is the logic behind exfoliative cytology, what exactly exfoliative cytology stands for. So talking about the history or its discovery, so it was introduced by George Panayiotou in 1941, and the technique, that is the preferred technique, there are several other techniques, but the most preferred common technique is, firstly you clean the surface of the oral lesion because of, if there is any presence of debris or mucin on it, so you slightly clear the oral surface or the oral lesion, scraping vigorously the entire surface of the lesion several times with either a metal spatula, a moistened tongue blade or a cyto brush, then collecting the material and then spread it evenly on a microscopic slide and fixing immediately before the smear dries off. Now these fixatives, the commercial preparation is of spray site, or you can also take 95% alcohol or equal parts of alcohol and ether. Don't worry, these all procedure will be clear as I'll be popping images here and videos here, so to make it more clear what I'm actually meaning with the word technique or the whole process. After the slide is flooded with the fixative, it should be allowed to air dry for 30 minutes. Okay, so this is actually a basic procedure for exfoliative cytology. This is an actual procedure. Slides are never flame fixed. Actually, the bacteriological slides when we make, so they are fixed by using over the flame. They are dried over the flame and then fixed. So these slides are never flame fixed. It is essential that the procedure be repeated and a second smear be prepared. That is, a duplicate procedure has to be performed and a duplicate slide has to be made. That is, two slides have to be prepared and a separate scraping to be done. Now, not with that scraping spatula or the cyto brush or a moistened tongue blade, a new scraping has to be done. Okay, two smears are always submitted from each lesion, since additional staining procedures are usually employed by the cytologist. So always two smear preparations are given. Now the cytological smears which you have given to the cytologist will actually be reported as falling into one of the five classes. Okay, so these are the five classes. The findings which the cytologist will give you will fall into these categories. Either it's going to be class 1, a normal condition, which indicates that only normal cells were observed and there is no pathology. Class 2 would be atypical condition, that is something abnormal, that indicates the presence of minor atypia, that is an abnormality, but no evidence of malignant changes are seen. There is an abnormality, but it is not malignant in nature or not cancerous. Okay, type 3 is indeterminate. This is in between cytology that separates the cancer from the non-cancerous diagnosis. The cells display wider ATPR, that is abnormality, that may be suggestive of cancer. Okay, so here there was a minor ATPR, that is a minor abnormality seen, but here there is a wider chance that is suggestive of cancer, but they are not clear cut and may represent a precancerous condition. Okay, that is not actually a cancerous condition but a precancerous condition. So what is a precancerous condition and a lesion? So a separate video have been made on it. What are these called? What is the definition? What are the examples? So you can watch it anytime. I'll give the link in the description box and also pop an I button. Or carcinoma in situ and biopsy is recommended. Now a separate video will be made on biopsy. So don't worry, where I'll tell the details of biopsy, what is biopsy, its types and everything. So abhi ke liye you can remember that biopsy is nothing but it's a surgical procedure of removing a tissue for the histopathological diagnosis. Okay, so then actually you can say exfoliative cytology is also a type of biopsy in a way, you can say. But because biopsy, when you read biopsy, you'll get to know that there are various types or various techniques even for biopsy. And exfoliative cytology, that is the scraping away as we have seen in exfoliative cytology, could be a type, you can say, in a way for biopsy. So biopsy, a whole video, separate video will be made on it. Okay. And it's a more diagnostic procedure for cancerous lesions than exfoliative cytology. Class 4 is suggestive of cancer, that is a few cells with malignant characteristics or many cells with borderline characteristics are there. So biopsy is mandatory for confirmation. And class 5 is positive for cancer, that is cells are obviously malignant and biopsy is again mandatory for confirmation. So got to know, one is normal, then something atypical or abnormal, then between stage, between a cancerous and non-cancerous thing, then suggestive of cancer and then positive for cancer. Okay, moving on to the uses of exfoliative cytology. So it is used for early detection and control of oral cancers, as we have seen. Also useful in the diagnosis of lesions of herpes simplex, herpes zosters, pemphigus, benign familial pemphigus, keratosis follicularis, white sponge nevus, etc. Other lesions also other than oral cancers. Assessment of pernicious and sickle cell anemias also. That is your nutritional deficiency anemias also. Cells retrieved from household objects like toothbrush for identification of a person or determination of the gender. So in short, they are saying that for age and sex determination, also in your forensic dentistry, exfoliative cytology is useful. Helpful in the follow-up detection of recurrent carcinomas in previously treated cases and predicting cellular responses of a tumor to irradiation. So these are the basic uses for exfoliative cytology. Moving on to the last part, we'll quickly see the indications, contraindications and advantages and disadvantages. Now this is very important because if a short note question is asked, these are the points which you should definitely mention so that you fetch good marks. Talking about the indications, they are indicated for multiple or large red lesions. In older patients who cannot tolerate surgical procedures because there is only scraping in this procedure, so it could be indicated for older patients. Also lesions located in region that presents surgical difficulty, patients with anticoagulant drugs or bleeding disorders, and biopsy contraindicated cases. So this is very basic, I suppose. Now you can devise them by own after knowing the procedure or the technique for exfoliative cytology and understanding the basics. These could be made by your own. Contraindicated in an obvious cancer that would justify biopsy. Matlab, an obvious cancer that would be justified by biopsy. A submucosal lesion, a dry crusted lesion as may be seen on the lips. A white lesion that does not rub off and unreliable patients. Talking about the advantages you have, it's a quick, simple, painless, that is non-invasive and bloodless procedure. Okay, minimum skills and instruments are required. It is cost effective and patient friendly also. Early diagnosis of the lesion can be made and it is easily done at chair side. Again, these are the advantages which you can make by your own because all you know about the procedure. So these could be made by you. Now you've known the procedure, the instruments required, the technique. So definitely you are well aware of the advantages. Also, the disadvantages could be because it's not a diagnostic procedure as compared to, as I've said, when we see the video on biopsy. So you will get to know that that's a more diagnostic or confirmatory procedure. So many times false negative results could be there. Chances of contamination is also there. Low sensitivity by exfoliative cytology or low sensitive results are there. Not usable in non-epithelial lesions. And it is not a substitute but only an adjuvant to surgical biopsy. That is, this is not, as you understood, like as we have seen in the various classes also, like biopsy is a confirmatory test. So it is just an adjuvant, that is an additional thing. If in any case surgical biopsy cannot be performed, then only this is then. But still now there is no any substitute for surgical biopsy, okay? So it is just an additional procedure, but biopsy is more confirmatory procedure. So this is all about exfoliative cytology, a very small topic yet important topic from exam point of view, for clearing your concepts also and for knowing the basics also. So if you enjoyed the video and you understood the basics of it and understood the concept, then please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Also hit the little bell so that you're notified every time we upload a video, and stay tuned for the lecture on biopsy coming soon. Thank you so much.